back for round two. Not going to play first once again. Pretty easy mulligan this time around. Even I would not keep this hand. Even I. What, Ben? You're over there.
Gerard Fabiano keep this hand?
Gerard Fabiano would 100% keep this hand. We're on the draw. He would see a spell bomb and he would snap keep. We're going to throw it back, though. We're going to go ahead and pause it because our opponent's probably not here since I took a little while getting to the match. And I'll be right back. All right, he's back. We're going to mulligan. We are currently arguing about various... We're currently arguing about various very bad hands to keep.
I mean, it's a control mirror with tectonic edges and man lands, and if you expect no one to play anything... I'm talking about unlimited.
Unlimited?
No way. All right. Spell you draw.
Can we keep this hand at six, please?
What? Yeah.
Okay, obviously. Thank you. We're discussing various hands over here, and we're being recorded, and they're talking about six lands Mindslaver hands.
I think you people are just joking. Like, and there's very few five land Mindslaver hands.
Sometimes you gotta give some loose action.
Mindslaver's not even good. Like, if I had five lands Mindslaver and X, there's very few cards X could be where I would keep that hand.
Isn't even true.
100% true. A five land is practically already a mulligan. I'd rather just get like three lands and three spells or whatever.
So you're saying three swamps, two islands, skin render. And
skin render would fill that X role, but if it was like Moriarch Reaver and Mindslaver and right. Five lands, I'm shipping.
Can I pause for a play scenario here? Would you guys Red Sun Zenith this Plague Stinger, or would you play Copper Mirror? That's what
Red
I thought.
Red Sun Zenith that Plague Stinger, you'll be dead.
That's what I thought. That's what I thought.
Skin render would be one of those few X's.
All right, so we've determined Ben would keep four land skin render Mindslaver, but he would not keep any other or very few other X's.
There are other cards it could be, but there's a lot of five land Mindslaver and a spell hands that I would mulligan. Where and keeping six lands Mindslaver is literally absurd. Like, not that any professional Magic players would do that.
You said Nassif kept it, or he argued to keep it?
I mean, it was in a FUD draft, so I don't know if he was taking it seriously, but he was arguing to keep it, and then he shipped it.
Naturally, we got to this discussion by talking about Gerard Fabiano keeping seven basic lands in the Pro Tour, or is it the Grand Prix? One of those two.
My issue with Gerard was that he kept, four forests, three mountains.
I know, four forests, three mountains.
I would keep four islands, three swamps. Are you kidding me?
You people make me sick. That is awful.
Wait. Can we please note what my opponent plays turn two Plague Stinger, so I turn two Red Sun Zenith it, and then he goes, oh my god, it looks like you got the pre-constructed sealed deck. I've literally played one spell. He played a Plague Stinger, and I disintegrated it, and all of a sudden I have the pre-constructed sealed deck because of my one spell.
Well, if you can afford to blow your disintegrator,
I mean, that could actually just be the best spell in my deck, and he does not know it at all. I mean, let's just... jumping to irrational conclusions after a single spell. People do this all the time on Modo. They get so tilted about something stupid like that.
Stop opening precons, Conley.
He casts turn 2 Plague Singer. That's like the best thing you could do in Infect on turn 2, and he's complaining about me killing it. He just virulent wounded my thing.
I'd complain, too, if my opponent opened the pre-constructed
seal. We didn't even know if we were white or green. It wasn't like 100% pre-constructed. It's definitely a good deck. But, like, to make that judgment off of a single spell, he's cast Virulent Wound, Perilous Mirror, and Plague Stinger so far. He is blue-black, which is interesting.
Seems like maybe it's
heat. Mirren, what the f- He's cast Virulent Wound, Plague Stinger, Mirren Crusader, and Perilous. And he's yelling at me for the pre-constructed deck. We're actually just going to die to this Phyrexian Crusader. Man, guys. Sure, glad we have that disintegrate. He's not even going to battle with the mirror. Doesn't even think it's worthwhile. He attacked last turn, but this time, not necessary. Oh, he's splashing green. Oh, there's a Blight Widow. He's cast all of his cards. They've been the nut high every time. We're dead. We're going to run out this 1-1 Darksteel Juggernaut that's going to die as soon as it attacks. Do we even do this? Is it worthwhile? I guess if it keeps this guy back for a turn, I guess it's worthwhile. We're going to need to draw Runner, Burn the Impure, Disintegrate, or something like that. You rip Phyrexian Ranger off the top, also a good card. Alright, so our guy's just going to die anyway, so I think we're just chump blocking here.
You think? You want to save 4 infect damage?
Well, you would jump block here, right? Yeah, of course. I would just note. I mean, we're on camera or video. So we're going to five. We then play Razorfield Rhino and a Contrary with one of his guys, which sucks when our six drop. Ooh, and saved by the Precursor Golem.
What do we have here?
All right. So I can throw 2-1. It'll kill. It'll first strike my guy. Make it a 1-1. Maybe I just Razorfield Rhino, block, take 2. No, I think we have to save poison damage. He could have like a pump spell or something.
You guys hungry?
Patrick Chapin eats more than just about anybody, apparently. We ate about 2 hours ago, maybe 3. He's hungry again. Alright, so our blocks are kind of interesting here. I think we kill the Phyrexian Crusader and then we just chump block the Blight Widow. We have 1-1 left over. We have 2-1-1s and a 3-3 after that. Sobok Lifestaff. Wow. Okay, so we have a... We lose one of our guys. And we have a 3-3 and a 1-1 after this. I guess that's fine. He just moved Sobok Lifestaff over twice. Which is interesting. And now he's attacking with Phyrexian Rager and Perilous Mirror. I'm uncertain of his game plan here. I think we will take the 4. Next turn we have a 6-6. So we're at 15 life, 5 poison. Trying to recover as bags of chips get crinkled in the background. Alright, so now he can't make that attack again. I think we're safe if he doesn't have removal spell. If he does, all bets are off, obviously. How sucky would it be to get Virulent Wounded on your Precursor Golem and it kills it? Be pretty nutlow. What?
Spend 2 forests, 2 mountains, 2 swamps.
Have you seen...
I mean, it depends on what you're playing against.
Now, I'm getting destroyed in this match.
It's a different scenario whose Broodmate is 2 spells in 1 and always good.
I'm getting absolutely destroyed in this match. You guys are discussing Broodmate Dragon Hands. Look, he's he just played...
Broodmate and Mindslaver aren't comparable. Like, Mindslaver...
No, I think Broodmate's much better.
Yeah, Mindslaver gets shattered a lot of the time. It doesn't even do anything if you didn't draw anything else. Broodmate can win the game straight up on its own. No,
so you keep that.
It depends what you're playing against. I think you could keep that a lot of the time.
So you two are...
Finally, start winning more.
He played Corrupted Conscience.
You might have a golem.
He just stole my 6-6.
I mean, there are certainly decks you mulligan that against as well, Pat. I mean, I think it depends on what you're playing against.
He stole my 6-6 and gave it infect. Silvok Replica. No. We're going to panic spell bomb something.
I would keep 6 mountains of Broodmate Dragon.
You're an animal.
Alright, we're hoping. Alright, we're dead. Should I scoop this? I'm going to scoop it. I guess we'll play it out and see if he punts, but I don't think we could possibly win.
I think there are definitely a lot. I think you keep that about half the time.
You know you guys are the worst video makers of all time.
The strategy that we're discussing and whether or not to keep 6 slimes of Broodmate is just as interesting as your match going on.
I don't know if it is. It's not relevant at all. I'm getting crushed by a 6-6 infect, a 2-4 reach infect, 2-2 first strike infect. He didn't even bother to move the Sylvok Lifestaff over. He's just that confident. Not attacking with anything else. We have to, like, throw guys in front of this stupid dude. I mean, I could theoretically try to draw, like, Sylvok Replica this turn, that seems so unlikely.
I don't even like playing with that card in limited.
Don't tell that to Owen Turnbull, he loves a Mindslaver. This has been the worst recorded draft of all time, I apologize, viewers. Get there! Wow. Alright, now we can officially scoop. Not a card in our deck. Sure glad we had the pre-constructed deck, though, to beat him. Alright, so he's infect, so we're probably going to be boarding something, I just don't know what. I don't want mana cost, I want color. Okay. Cost Courier is fine against him. Ogre Resistor, I think, is a necessity. Blight Mamba is a potential card. Although, to be fair, all this infect stuff is flying or big. Um, How much do you like Trigon of Infestation as a board card against Infect?
They have small guys. I don't know if I like it that much against him. Yeah, it's not good against the 2/2 first strike, Infect. And it's also just not very good against the size of his creatures.
I'd definitely bring in an Ogre Resistor, because they had like Blight Widow and stuff.
Yeah.
I just don't know
what... Yeah, I like Ogre Resistor against him. That trades with the 2/2 first strike, Infect, right?
Yes.
That's a big game.
That is a big game. What do you like taking out? Clone Gel, or a Spell Bomb, or... Propagator? No, Propagator's pretty good, I guess. If you get him on...
Propagator's bad. I would take him.
You think so?
Yeah.
I guess he had Virulent Wound.
Not only that, it's just, like, it's way too slow. Like,
what about,
for decks where you're gonna have stalemates and
stuff. How do you feel about these Cost Couriers? We got two of them.
They're fine.
Unnecessary, just because they're kind of...
Yeah, I mean, you probably want them. I mean, I don't know. You could cut your Rusted Relic and then get in the Ogre Resistor and those, and you'll have a lot more flash. I'd probably do that.
Okay. Do we cut... oh, we probably just cut Darksteel Juggernaut, too. It's not even good in this matchup.
Yeah, exactly. Anyways. Cut the Juggernaut. Cut all that shit. Cut the Relic. Cut the Relic.
Yeah, we're good. The only thing left we have is Razorfield Rhino, which is a 4-4. I think it's...
Yeah, there you go. And get in all those nice red and green bodies. There you go.
They are in. The only other option we have is Kuldotha Ringleader or Nathasaur over Razorfield Rhino, but it's basically the same card, just with less upside.
Right.
I guess we could bring in Azuri's Archers over Rhino.
Did he have Flyers?
Yeah, he had Plague Stinger.
Just one?
That's all we saw, yeah.
Kind of dicey.
All right, we'll just play it as is. We have enough removal. I think we should be good.
Plenty of shock effects if you draw those ones.
Yeah.